give up.
I give up.
Here we go, let's do it.
I don't drink it.
Where's my phone?
Good to have you here. Get out of Minnesota.
Yeah.
Go where it's warm.
Yeah.
All the heaters are turned up too high.
Well, I'm going to Russia myself, I think, next summer again.
Are you going to go with the...
Sharon.
This guy's a mess.
Last time I went, I had a few people who liked me, and I had a number of people who despised me. I didn't hesitate to point out that we got to look at ourselves to see who really started the Cold War.
All right.
And it was the original Minnesota, the Elena Lena's cheetah.
Yeah, it's a very, very nice one.
It is.
Yeah, I just sent it out. I should. I'll send it.
I'm not saying you're interviewing me.
No, I don't. These things always kind of.
Oh, yeah.
I remember.
I just.
She went. She was on her daughter tour. She does.
Yeah.
Oh, wow. Yeah.
So there's stuff. He has been doing this. Kind of spill.
I always mention when people ask me to do Russia. I don't wear. Popcorn or something. I think that was a mark.
Are you making attempt to?
What's that?
I'm making you don't wanna sit in the front row, you can sit in the other way. In the front row because I don't know.
That's what you mean.
It was, it's possible to social distance. I still feel I'm going to do that a little bit, so.
I weren't eating popcorn, I'd have my mask on.
Oh.
Well, I wear it everywhere. I don't care what people think. I don't need a breakthrough case.
That's true.
I'm too old and I have too many conditions.
Oh, well, that's one thing to consider for sure.
Well, I think we're waiting for my neighbor.
Your house looks so much like the one next door, I always hesitate. Which one is it again?
Right, they are from the outside almost, they're like identical twins, but they're not the same.
And it's been a while.
Yeah, they're not the same. They were done at the same architect, right? They're two models of the same idea, but they're organized differently inside. So I frankly like mine better. I like my organization better than theirs.
There are a lot of houses in my area that look like mine too. I think they probably worked from the same basic plan and then added touches that differentiated them. As you go up around Powderhorn Park, you know, there's a lot of them that are the same design.
Yeah, there's six, like my house, you know, two block area. Or seven, there's seven.
Really?
Layout's the same, the inside is roughly the same, they're just slight differences.
Would you know, is it one of those Sears catalog houses?
It's not.
Oh, okay, because there are a lot of those in the room.
Yeah, no, I looked it up, it's just somebody did all these on spec, but slightly. Mine's 18 inches wider than a couple of the other houses, but they have much cooler woodwork and even little stained windows, so.
Well, that makes sense. It saves effort on the architect's part.
Right.
I'm sure back then people thought that way too.
The first owner's name was Sophronia. Sophronia was her name. Sophronia Brown. And the person I bought it from was
Elsie.
It was Elsie, but her sister who owned, her sister-in-law who owned it was Sophronia Stroop.
Really?
Yeah. I mean, whose name is Sophronia?
In one minute it'll be a fashion.
Sounds like a southern name.
I know, doesn't it?
Well, progress came late to the south, so that's probably why it was a southern name for so long. There are a lot of black people named Sophronia.
Oh, okay.
Really?
Mm-hmm.
Because it's a southern name. So how has life been, Tom? Have you been able to give lessons?
Yeah.
I've got a couple. I only have two students, but they're the best. here we go.
I wore my hooded jacket too.
Hi.
Hi.
Nice to meet you, Kathy.
Hi.
Hello.
Yeah, that's fine.
Cavalier's house. All kinds of little things. Cats.
He says, well,
Bay means beyond Bay Call.
Right.
So it's the zone right next to Lake Bay Call. That's, they just mean the part right past Lake Bay Call.
Okay, so that doesn't go all the way to the ocean?
No, it does not.
My friend Sally, that you may remember from a previous recital, sent me a Lake Bay Call face mask. I should have worn it.
Are we all set? I gotta turn my phone off.
Oh, yeah, I did turn mine off.
Stupid thing is so noisy.
Yeah.
Chris, when I hit do not disturb, it'll be 3 days from now that I go, I'm not getting any calls.
Oh, right, yeah.
I can't figure it in between.
It's in my coat. I'll leave it out there.
Everybody ready? Bathroom? Anybody? Oh, and I guess I'll just say, my cats, especially Homo, will sit on people's laps, and if you don't like them, just shoo them off.
Okay.
And if you do like them, beware. He will get really affectionate and start biting you and clawing you. In which case, you dump them off again.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
Okay, well, this will be an intermission, but we won't do it too long. It's kind of, you know, we'll keep moving. So, help yourself.
Sure.
Well, thank you very much. Wow, that was lovely. And funny. And full of skin.
Sure.
Yes. Okay, you have time, don't you?
No, I'll pretend I do.
Just put everything in.
Also.
Everything. This is trash.
Molto moderna. I just wanted to be moderate.
Nobody else is in there.
I didn't see molto moderna.
No, I have so many skeptics here. So many skeptics, but I thought you'd already gone. Let's get the turn to work.
It's the other little, but not too fast, you know, the.
Yeah, no trouble, yeah. I don't ever see trouble.
It's a trouble, yeah.
Little trouble.
I'm making skeptics.
We have grandson.
I don't know that word at all. You haven't heard it?
Oh, nice.
You just read it?
Or skeptic?
No, I never heard that word.
Oh, no, I see what you mean. No, I haven't either. Which I should be that surprised.
And it's just all these, breaks.
I know.
Really?
Those are fun.
They go here and they'll be just like, they're so busy now.
Mm-hmm.
It's kind of really surprising.
Are you still hosting a meditation? Huh? Are you still hosting a meditation?
Well, I don't know.
Oh, not for all time, okay.
How are your parents?
Hanging in.
Good.
Oh, yeah, Tom's parents are.
Now, when do you go to Siberia?
Oh, this Sunday.
We're going to the house.
I'm up there now.
Oh.
Do you stay at those families?
This will be the first, that's not that style, but I am staying.
Oh, no.
That was actually remarkable. One of my friends, as I assume, every once in a while. And she said, so are you going on this trip? What are your plans? And she said, so do you know where you're staying? And I said, well, I'm moving out to my home.
My dad and his girlfriend also went to the.
And she said, oh, you can stay with us.
Oh, yeah.
And in all of her.
Yeah, she was a 103. Oh.
Nobody's ever even wanted to ask that question because apartments are small. They were really crappy. They were embarrassing. And so on. And it's not, you don't do that to a guest.
No, I forgot to.
It's not, American style is, we like it so little.
Oh, yeah.
Theirs is, they're the best. So actually, my host is renting an apartment for me. And I said, oh, man, I hope I can reimburse you to do something. Come on, because we're friends. And she wrote back in no uncertain terms and says, absolutely not, and don't you dare bring that up again. I mean, without humor. I told her, because it's a matter of, you know, you don't have to do that. What I said was rude. But I thought we were friends. So my response was, well, you know, the nicest people I know are you guys. Are you guys? You're my models for this. And the thing is, I can't square that what I learned about you guys from here in America. You're all crumb. So, how am I going to do this? How am I going to understand this?
So while you're gone, what do you do with your cats?
I don't know. I drown them. Why are you laughing?
No,
my neighbors are going to take care of
them. Drown them with love by the other neighbors.
You're all my neighbors. I take care of theirs, they take care of mine. You got a group of them.
Oh, that's wonderful.
Yeah. In fact, I do kind of elaborate feeding. And I read the problem, do everything I say. I told them you can do the simple version, but no, they'll do twice a day. And, you know, can I say?
Well, it's nice that you don't have to board them. Yeah.
Oh, God, I've never even been in that position.
It really is traumatizing.
I'm sure it would be. Well, it's traumatizing that I'm leaving. You know, I know that.
Where did you? decide she taught?
No, not on this. This is just a moment.
I'll give you a chance to try Russian winters and compare them to Minnesota winters.
I've done it.
Oh, I have you?
Yeah.
Which are worse, ours? I've heard ours are worse.
What's the worst? If you want worse, move to Sarasota.
Is this the one in here?
My father's from a place.
I've got more glasses. If you're worried about it, I've got more. They're just going to this one.
I know.
You sure that's yours? No.
Yeah.
You said your father's from where?
He's from a small town near Kissimmee. And I've spent a lot of time down there, and thanks, but no thanks.
I hope you see a bunch of people.
Well, that's what I'm going for. I'm actually going for three reasons. One, because we made a grant for the orphanage that we deal with, and we haven't been able to give it. Because the person that received our money, we would wire money to an individual, and she died.
Oh.
And we can't find anybody who wants to do that with good reason, because it's considered income. And we send them $75,000. And that's a significant bump in income, and then you got the tax on it. So nobody wants that. She didn't care. She was retired. She doesn't care. She knew about it. Everybody kept warning her. So the irresponsible one here is her. Right? What's she doing kicking the bucket? She's
how dare she?
Yeah.
How dare she? Exactly. Such bad timing.
Meeting Tom in the lurch.
Such bad. Well, not just me.
So if you deliver it in person, that's considered a different sort of transaction?
No. It's all the same. The thing is, how do you get the money over there? And not lose it. Wiring money costs about $50 or $100. $50 to $100. Carrying money is free.
Ah.
Yeah, except it's dangerous.
Right, until you.
Right. I don't think that the actual danger is that bad, because I'm going to be in a really controlled situation.
Can't you hide it in your shoes?
I'm not wandering around with this. I'm not taking a train. I'm going on airplanes. I'm going to be in three airports. I'm going to be always in transit. And always, then I'm going to land there, and then I'm going to say, here. I take this. Actually, I won't be able to give it to them, but I'll be able to give it to my host.
So you're not going to check their bag?
I haven't
seen it, no.
I don't think it
was. Well, that's what I would
say. To check cash. But, and Western Union, you can do it, but it's not very good. The other thing would be PayPal. But PayPal gets checked unless it's family.
Mm-hmm.
And clearly none of us are family. You know, sending money to family. But we are going to check. See, I'm a godfather. Last I saw the boy, he was at his christening in 2019. 6 months ago. He was 3 in January. So I get to see him as a person. And we're gonna look into whether that should constitute family. Mm. You know, the family mentality for the government to say, oh, of course, godfather's same money. And then you can be the laundry. The money laundry. You know, that's how much I said, but The other thought was to try to get a whole bunch of people to have PayPal accounts. And if we just send $200, $300 to a bunch of people who are all, so they're all these volunteers connected to the orphanage. And so I'm going to go there and I'm going to say, what do you think about this? And you guys will each get it a little and then you just collect it. And you do that a couple times a year and see how that works. I mean, ideally, we'd wire straight to the orphanage, but I'm not going to ask her why that's not going to be. She doesn't seem to want to do it, and I'm going to find out why.
In what form is the cash going to be? $100 bill?
Is what's going to be.
Really?
Although she wrote to me, I already asked, is this okay? And she said, well, the only hard part is about it is going to be the exchange. And so I'm just thinking, I'll do the exchange for her. I'll exchange money. I don't know if that has a problem. That gives a problem to me. I don't know.
How much money you're transferring?
Well, it's a lot.
Country.
It's a lot. I have to declare.
More than 10,000, they become excited.
No. I have to declare more than 3,000. Going into Russia. That's the number I need. That's why I wasn't worried, because I'm not bringing it. I'm not bringing it.
they want funds coming in.
Well, I fully expect them to think, yeah, the thing is, if I'm not on a business visa, I can't leave with more money than I came in with. So they wanted to work, and I'm gonna leave with my own cash.
Yeah.
That's not even my money, right, it's gonna be like.
Yeah.
I don't see why any of this.
You're just living it up.
Right, I'm just, and then they'll say, what's it for, and I'll tell them, and then I'll show them the website, so this is what we do. And actually, there was this big lady in our corner of board that she personally, the director of this orphanage, and the orphanage, could get trouble because we're an NGO, Reformed American, specifically, and there's this whole thing about sort of foreign agents. And I have never personally worried about this at all, because we're so tiny. And we deal in such small amounts of money. And, you know, that it's just stupid to think that this means anything, really. And it's, but these board members want to do that, so I said, all right. And so I wrote that question, said, we're worried that in this horrible political moment, that you're gonna get tarred with being friends of Americans and receiving money from Americans, and you specifically, and, you know, it could be bureaucracy, people who work, you know, whatever, she said. But she wrote back 2 days later and said, I went down to the authorities and asked the security for this, you know, regional security, which means federal security, for her town and region, and said, they're going to send this, I told them enough, they're going to bring this much money for us. And they've been doing this since 2010, this is the biggest amount of it. And they said, they said, you need this relationship. You know, you have this long relationship and you need this stuff. So what would be the problem? And that's the thing.
Right.
We sit over here in TV land, in politics land, and think that, you know, and all the experts who think they know, you know, about
the money is just buying food and supplies and all spent over.
Well, yeah, well, of course it is. No, that's not the issue. Yeah. The issue is we're not friends with. And so somehow that's supposed to bleed down to this local level. And it doesn't have anything to do with anything. Actually, that's not 100% true. It has bled down. It has bled down. And every time I've had an encounter, the first one was hilarious. It was a taxi driver who sat with my friends, and they were waiting to pick me up. And he went on and on and on about the angles. And they said, so who are we picking up? He says, you'll see. And I sat next to him in the taxi, and my Russian friends. And he goes, so where are you going to go? Well, I don't know. This is where are you? And he said, I'm American. Really? What are you doing here? And I said, well, I'm doing this and doing this. And, you know, use my crappy Russian and everything. He says, oh, well, you're a nice guy. Well, that's different. You know, and it took 30 seconds to break this thing. And Elena, Elena has said she's worried about her students because they are hearing all this stuff. And I hate to take their side, but we're the aggressors in this. We're the ones causing the problem. They are responding reasonably. And I say reasonably, they're going to respond to their own propaganda because they have to have their team with them. And so they're going to do that stuff. And so every time I show up, there's some little incident that goes, what are you doing here? You're an American, what are you doing? And everybody is great. Nobody holds on to this.
Well, if I may add, let's be fair. They've got legitimate concerns of large sums of money coming in, exactly, and doing things to interfere in.
Well, of course. No, I know, but yeah. I know. That's exactly right. What they said. But the problem is the amount of money.
Right. No, you're obviously not.
But the thing is, the specifics are the issue. The generality of foreign agents and bringing money in is irrelevant. It's utterly irrelevant. It looks relevant when you sit around and talk about it. But when you say you're bringing a grant to an orphanage and it's been done repeatedly and you just explain what the thing is, they go, oh, sure. You know.
Well,
that's
a great response.
But the thing is, it's the true response.
Yeah.
The thing is, and I was saying to our board member, they said, you were worried about this in 2018 when I got the director of this orphanage, who really is a town. She's recognized as a town. It's just the most depressed area, and they've got no funding and all this, but she's something, and she's really smart, and she organizes and she puts stuff together. Anyway, so So she's succeeded in finding outside money, and this whole system of dealing with kids without parents who can support them. So when they say orphan, it's just that most of them are not real orphans, right? And most of the parents are in jail or drugs or something like that. They have parental rights to meet. Bit by bit by bit, they've had their funding reduced and reduced. They're trying to shift to a foster program, right? Mm-hmm. And you just can't jump into that. You've got to have another class for that. You've got to have people to take them on. So they're working on that. But it's switched to where they suddenly, now they must get housing. They must, they now experience it. They've never been a charitable organization. They've been, the board of the state. So there is we are the other big donor to this orphanage. There's a doctor who founded a hospital that also gives personally, not the hospital, he personally gives. And then these donations are not mine, they're our donors' money. And we give approximately the same. And she gave a presentation to orphanages. They had a conference in Vladivostok for Far Eastern orphanages, and she gave a presentation about how she's managing to handle the finances and the changes in the laws. And she showed us this presentation, showed us the PowerPoint when I went and visited. And there it was, we have to raise money, and here's Segregated Bridges, they gave us this much, here's Davida. He gave us this much, and we've gotten this much from local donations, we've got this much from cheaper donations, we've got this. She just spelled the whole thing out in public. And famously, we got two people who have all this background in the Soviet world. And everything's under the table. And she's got put now, I said, where do you want the money? She says, let's make a presentation. So here I am with my cash in 2018 going, well, dollars! Because he wants it to be totally public. Now, there are still bureaucratic problems that she loses. She says, that's our money, and bit by bit, the bureaucracy has made it so that she can't handle her own money anymore. She knows how much it is, and she hands it over to them, and she has to be requesting it. And there's just no way around that. That's just gotten worse and worse. And she never gets back to the mom. Every single bit we give is all goes to sound the orphanage. But there's no way she says she never gets all back. But if she's really careful about it, she can keep track of those two. And it's also a lot of hobby. Make friends, but not just make sure that she's fine.
But it's young
money. That's what I'm saying. It's young. So I don't know how bad it is in our business, but she said, she said, don't worry about it. How can we make sure we get it all the money? This is what we're supposed to do. Because I have to hear over it. We don't hide anything. And she always gives us. But we always get into accounts of our money. Down to the room. Big spreadsheets. This is the amount of money. And then part of your business is you want that with your money? And then you want that with your money? We're able to do this with your money? Told me that she liked that piece. So I played it in a concert there in 2014, and she told me of all the stuff that I played, she liked that. So that's the only thing I know that she liked, so I thought I'd play that. But there are two other people from, so I've known, and this is my, this is a picture of, this is very silly, but it's a, it's the last picture she sent me. So it's the thing that's a hoot, it's a busted cabbage, right? It's like somebody forgot to clean up the garden.
Is she wearing it?
She's wearing a cabbage suit. But she goes, I'm gonna, well, I'll be going to the doctor. Her friend Victor, and his wife, Lynn, has dodged and basically deserves it as well. So she goes to work tomorrow. Anyway, so I've known her since 1993. And the truth is I don't remember from 1995, but she swears I knew her in 1995, but that's okay. But my friend Alec Gottlieb, who was my, nominally my Russian instructor, horrible student, pretty bad teacher, but we were good smoking buddies. and he was a very, very close friend. He didn't take care of himself. He died about 8 years ago. So he's one of the people I knew really, really well. And then my first translator for when I went to play the first time and the second time. Well, she was part of the second. And then just very, very, very close friend, Tanya Tsukhanova, who's my age, died very tragically in 2018 from a stroke and a, well, when they had the stroke, when she ended up in the hospital, they found she had a brain tumor. So she was in very bad shape. And so I got these three original friends from the place. It's like the old guard.
Yeah.
Well, died. Bombs. So anyway, I'm saying I'm playing the Schubert for them. now the Brahms also is I didn't pick this. The woman who picked was my teacher, Mrs. Wen, from age 9 to 15. And she lives actually out where my right near my parents. When I play, her husband died earlier this year, and I went and played for her, and she said, "Yeah, that's nice, but can you play some Brahms? Can you play some Mozart?" And she didn't just say some; she said, "Can you play Opus 118?"
Oh, she
said, "Yeah, specific pieces, and also a specific Mozart." Well, so I'm playing from. I'm not playing all six of them, but I'm playing four of them. So that this is for Mrs. Wayne.
And who's putting it underneath?
That's another teacher of mine. He's his name's Seymour Hayden. He died 2 years ago. Cancer. Yeah, he's a very close friend of the Wends. He was a professor of mathematics, but also this unbelievable harpsichordist. And he finally quit math completely and just became a harpsichordist. And he taught me some, you know. And he was a really, really good friend. So, I didn't have that many lessons with him, but nevertheless. And then the other thing is that I'm playing all these Rachmaninoff because I feel like I've been going to Russia for now 32 years, and I ought to play some Russian music. So I have played a few Rachmaninoff in the past, but I never felt like I did it very well. And I'm not sure that I'm doing it well now, but it's better. And quantity helps. So I know I did 5 or 4 before, and I really made a hash of the second piano concerto, or I might not pronounce the second piano concerto. I really destroyed that one. But anyway, so this is for my Russian friends.
Yeah.
Right. So now it's not a program; it's a memorial or something.
Thank you.
this is a piece I made up, it's called Carefree. And I've been in the recital, you've heard it. No, but, too bad. Okay. So it's, I'll tell you what the number is. It's like opus 2. two. What was three number two?
What was three number two?
From 1892, and the ones I played are all, well, 1903, mostly 1903. And the two tableaus were all from the, what was 33, and that's 1911.
When was he born?
1873.
Yeah, I played that in high school.
Yeah, I actually taught some of that. All the notes are manageable. You just gotta get yourself around. Yeah, that, which is really, you know.
When I was that age, that was a weird thing to do.
Nice big chord.
Yeah.
Really?
I thought it sounds so unbelievably grand.
Well, I'm glad I'm at the trip.
Thanks. So do I. I gotta pack one. I packed the gifts. But I haven't had my stuff. In fact, my plan was, the only one I don't have is my host.
Where do you hope to play?
Honestly, I don't know.
2 years ago, she mentioned, so there's this main hall, which I don't have, I won't play.
It's like Minnesota. Right, so some small, you know, like all the money. But she lives in a factory town, suburb, in fact, it's a major ash bag, cold bag, everything. And so there's always this, it's kind of cool, frankly. It's a modern, it's a 1970s planned community, Soviet style. And so the construction is kind of ugly. And you know, it's just the actual construction. The society isn't so bad. It's just kind of like you need to get a square marker. You need to just clean up that cement a little bit. That kind of stuff. But the thing is, it's obviously more cars. So it's all these courtyards. It's all this. It's all a big block, building block. Nice size apartments. And I lived there 2 years ago, in their apartment. And it's kind of nice, you know? It's not, there are cars everywhere, but they can't drive. It's only for parking. Right now, everybody's cars. But it's still, you know, a walking place. And then you look out the window, there's a kitchen plan. You know, it's all playgrounds and stuff. I don't know, I like. But anyway, that area has its own hospital. Just talk about that. So maybe, but the one thing, one place I'm 99% sure library, which is right there, which is this little library. And I hope I can stream from it, because it's just a little upright now, and a little room. And I know the librarian, that's what she's up about. So I hope I do that. And then the other one I would love to do, this was a friend of hers, I played an army base. So this used to be a big army town. Very, very important. It's not anymore. But they still have this tank training base, which is nationally famous for World War II. And so I played at, so the place is gone. You know, it's all, so I like the offices. I love the shows. Like, there hasn't been anything in there for 20 years. And this woman decided she was going to make something of it for the kids. And then she got out of piano. And there's this piano, the grand piano with the long off its legs and back, and it's so low. But she got this upright, and these like 40 privates. And then the tank, you know what it means?
Yeah.
And there's all these short guys with a short margin, and then they all sit there and I go, and then they ask all these questions about, like, what are you doing? they don't pay much.
Oh, oh my God.
Just people, just
well, it just means that everything else songs in the country following the car.
Well, no, no, no. Yeah, no. But no, we've had that.
When the roads were falling.
This is the last 4 years. You just spread out all over the place.
And I'm not talking about now.
No, I know, no, no. We're making mistakes, so. So we call our hearts, they didn't attend.
Yeah.
I've heard that from several people. And what was it that nobody did people do when I'm not, now people don't. They want some of that, but they don't want that whole thing back. But, they just didn't attend to it as well. Remember, it was late, it was not a good one. It was a good idea. The glass was supposed to add up. That just new structure. And it just immediately said, the workers should own back. Except that I'm back. Right. And so they do this and then it, set up what's going on.
Now you got all of our sucking.
Well, no, I'm not saying that's.
Well, I know, so how can you possibly?
Well, the thing is, Putin has done it. Absolutely, he is in the thrall of big business, of course. But he's also held some of it to account. He's, what I understand is he has his type. What do you call it? Highwire. Highwire. His strongman stuff. He's not the biggest strongman in the world at all. But he does strongman stuff because that's one way of handling it. Of being able to manage this to try to guide it.
No,
I'm not for you. Yes,
he's
not.
Oh,
she needs to be.
Sure.
But we keep it as also the contract that you wait, maintenance staff is all keepers. Yeah. Right. Right.
Thirty-five years later, whatever.
Yeah.
Well, meet those guys on the train. Much.
Anyway, I agree with that.
It's so.
I'm.
I am. I'll.
Right. Happy travels. Thanks.
Sure.
Happy travels.
Thanks.
Apologize, you're the only shooter.
Oh, yeah, that's not nice.
Oh, really?
I just.
I did too!
Follow me. It says to a phrase like this. Well, thanks. I did one of those answers, right? Yeah. this. Grace will do that, which is just, you know, my favorite, like, I call it, Gracie, you were such a cute pie.
Yes, yes, you were.
This was a disaster. I don't know.